an exclusive on VIPboxing.tv here from the Victoria Warehouse, Old Trafford, Manchester. This contest is for 3 minute rounds of boxing in the super middleweight division. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the black leather shorts trimmed with silver. At the weighing he scaled 11 stone 9 pounds. Tonight is his 34th professional appearance. Presenting from Llanelli, Wales, via his homeland of Poland, presenting Robert Studzinski. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the black, claret and gold colored shorts. At the weighing, he scaled 11 stone, 5 pounds, 5 ounces. His outstanding record this evening reads, 5 contests, 4 wins with just a solitary defeat. He hails from the Pat Barrett and Polly de Silva camp via his hometown, home city of Salford, presenting Chris Fatboy Monaghan. Time for the bell, Gary Brennan. Star referee Phil Edwards in charge of the action. 4 3-minute rounds.
Someone told me before Monaghan's nicknamed Fatboy, I can't see why. He's looking good, good shape. Looking ready for this. Here we go, this is potential for fight of the night. 4 3-minute rounds. Starting off with a nice jab.
Chris coming out nice and sharp, nice and early. Working behind the jab.
Studzinski's in the all black shorts. Monaghan's got the golden trim and the red trim on. Wild shot from Studzinski. He's looking to catch him early. Monaghan's looking sharp though.
Plenty of feinting.
Good speed on the jab as well. He's looking good. Nice body shot. They're both looking eager to land here early on.
Just missing with the uppercut then. Firing the right hand up to the body was great.
Nice work to the body.
Looking nice and sharp here, Chris. Using plenty of movement. Boxing behind a sharp jab.
Studzinski's a very dangerous guy. 3 wins so far in his career, 2 of them's by knockout. He's got that one punch power you've got to be careful of. That's a nice right hand over the top.
Still firing that jab sharp, Chris, looking good.
Yeah, Monaghan's looking quick, looking the quicker of the two. That's a nice shot again. Coming forward.
Great body
now.
Shot. Nice and sharp.
If you were in there now, how would you think beating the Studzinski guy? Keep coming forward with a jab?
Yeah, probably keep coming forward. He moves head a little bit more. He seems a little bit stiff, a bit rugged to anything, but Chris is doing well here, so working behind a jab, fighting him straight right hand, looking good.
The hooks look to be landing as well. That's a nice uppercut though.
It's the second uppercut I've seen landing up to now.
Yeah, that's a nice shot.
Great shot.
I think it was more of a trip on the boards on the outside and a stumble, but the shot got through. You can hear the support he's got tonight. A lot of people have come to see him. Much like Lee Carter, there's a lot of people in here.
Putting shots together well there, Chris. Body and head, putting your body shot back to uppercut.
That's a nice uppercut through the middle.
Oh, he's Chris looking sharp tonight. Seems to be settling a little bit too now, looking a bit better, feeling more comfortable. Looking for that right hand behind the ear.
Good round, how'd you score that one?
Cracking first round. I think if that's a Chris, I thought Chris got that quite comfortably.
Looking sharp with that jab early on. This is is the fourth time Studzinski, the fifth time, sorry, Studzinski's been to the Victoria Warehouse. He's only been stopped five times in 30 contests. If Monaghan gets him out of here tonight, it's a real big achievement.
Just been upstairs with a very, very disappointed Lee Carter. Missed the first round there. How's it gone? How did you have it, Ryan?
We get the first round to Chris, he boxed sharp, he was in and out. To be fair, I thought he won it quite comfortably.
Here's a question for you both. Tweet in now. Next weekend, Crawler Linares. Who have you got for that one?
I'm a Crawler fan, to be fair. I'm a Manchester lad, so I'll back Crawler to the end. I think he's got it.
Simon?
I'll be honest with you. When the fight was first made, I fancied Anthony to stop him. Then as the fight got a little bit closer, but Linares might have one last swan song left in him. I'm edging back towards Crawler. I think it's one of them fights. I think it's a five-star fight. You know, we had that farce last week with Golovkin and Brook. You know, that was never a headline should fight over here. You know, I've got my opinion on that. We've lined Kell Brook's pockets with £3 million. Yeah, he took a fractured eye socket for it, but like I say, that's a real fight, Crawler Linares. And obviously, it'd be great to see Ryan Doyle, the man sat next to me, get back on the undercard of them fights. Hopefully. People still talk about your fight with Isaac Lowe, and I think the performance put in against Ryan Bailey, how dedicated it was, mate. I'm going to kiss your ass a little bit here, mate, but let's see you back on them shows to see a bit of pressure on Mr. Wood.
Yeah,
good
definitely.
To you now, mate.
Yeah, definitely looking for them over the fights now, the big fights of Isaac and that, especially Ryan Wolf and the British. The division's hard at the minute.
Ian Bailey as well, I've seen he's getting put in there with Reese Bellotti next. What,
that's it. Well, it could be a Bailey, Doyle or Bailey trilogy, couldn't it? Because if, like I say, I think he's, is it an English title final eliminator, so he could come by mandatory, so it could be a trilogy between us.
Great body work there from Monaghan. No, Monaghan was really hurt.
Oh, but great shot.
I was really hurt with that the Darryl Sharp performance. He was disappointed with himself. He's come out tonight, this is a lot better. Sharper shot, body, head. This is all a few tickets.
Monaghan's really busy in there now, landing a lot of shots. You know what you're going to get from Studzinski though? He's going to stand there and take it. Not going to give in.
Monaghan seems to be settling down now, firing the shots over. He's looking for that left hook to the body.
Nice head movement, body movement. Looking very busy in there, landing a lot of shots. The volume will start to take its toll, especially as we end the rounds.
Great second round for Chris. I think he's boxing nice and sharp.
As hello to Johnny West, my friend from the Valleys. Big Martin Murray fan, he's joining in, he's joining us. Lovely body shot again from Monaghan. By the way, caught the returning body shot on the arms as well. Nice jab.
It's a nice shot again, right hand over the top.
So he's looking for the left up to the body and the right behind the ear.
Tough kid, Studzinski. He's had some great fights on VIP boxing.
Shaping up to be a good fight this, not even halfway through yet. It's a nice shot from Studzinski. Monaghan's catching a lot of these shots on the glove zone, firing back with nice crisp shots. Working the body well. Good round again from Monaghan.
Monaghan can sustain his pressure. I won't be surprised if he can get a stoppage in the next round, maybe the fourth. He's working the head and body well. Firing fast, sharp shots. Looking good.
Viewing figures in Wales have gone through the roof. I don't know if they're joining in for Studzinski. We've got Matthew the Tyler who's watching. I don't know if that's where he spends most of the time at the end of a night out or if that's his occupation.
Just got a tweet in. Chris needs to move his head more. You can see what he's throwing a mile off. What do you think to that?
I like that, Doyle. You know, I think that head movement's getting a lot better. If you get asked a tricky question, mate, a little slip of the shoulders and pass it to the claymaker. I like that.
You like that?
Yeah, I don't think that's a little bit critical of Monaghan. I think, yeah, he is telegraphing some of his stuff. It's because he's so desperate to put a performance on tonight.
Here we go, round.
He's loading up on his shots. He's letting combinations go. Great jab from Monaghan. What about Ryan, anything on the horizon? I don't mean nights out and things like that, mate, and hot dates. I know you're a bit of a ladies man, but what about Any fight dates coming up? November 19th?
No, nothing.
Have been rumoured for you?
I'm just waiting for Steve to get back to me. That's it. I'm just ticking over now, ticking over in the gym, and hopefully a big fight on the horizon.
Lovely left hand there as well from Monaghan, and then a body assault. We're watching your Snapchat as well this week, mate. It's a bit different not seeing you up buildings and stuff like that. I've been working hard in the gym with Murray, and seeing Rob was in doing a little bit with you as well, weren't he?
Yeah, like I said, I'm just ticking over, doing the circuit training, staying fit.
That didn't look like ticking over, mate. I was going to sweat on watching them Snapchats.
No, ticking over, right? That's not even the beginning. I just started.
Monaghan can be really happy with his first few rounds so far.
First two rounds running big for me. Cruising this round as well, firing that right hand over the top.
I think that right hand was thrown from the Colliers gym and it still landed. Great shot from Monaghan. Looks like he's enjoying himself in there. 1-2s are going in.
Missing the two shots there.
I think them two were in yesterday's Manchester Evening News that just missed then.
I throw some of them.
Looking good in there, Monaghan.
Do you know, Monaghan's just not allowed Studzinski to rest in there just to get anything set up. He's peppered him with shots.
Studzinski doesn't seem to know what to do. He's coming forward and then going back with his hands up, hands down.
I think one fight definitely Monaghan would like to hear. I think Monaghan wants to fight Darrell Sharp again. He's not said it, it's just there's something this performance is saying to me.
Good solid performance, throwing him straight right hand. Looking sharp. Got to put his punches together, you know, using the body and head. Disguises him well.
Right, guys, I'm going to leave you again. It's been a pleasure.
Oh,
thanks
here we go.
Put
the pressure now, he's going
to
go. Come on, keep some pressure on. I won't be surprised and get a stoppage here. Just needs to keep pushing forward. Boxing sharp.
Monaghan's not got a stoppage yet so far in his career, but he's carried his power going forward. You can see that.
He's
bouncing around. Right,
oh, he's going.
To
me, I wouldn't be surprised if he doesn't go this round, maybe the next. Great left up.
Working the body very, very well. Studzinski's feeling it, you can see. Another one there.
Monaghan's just telegraphing his shots a little bit for me. He's setting them up, you can see him a mile off. He's the pace himself.
Monaghan again for me. Good round.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just have your attention please for an important announcement. A maroon Mazda, if you're the owner of a maroon Mazda, you're blocking an ambulance in. Thank you. Registration Tango 654.
Appeal for a card just gone up in the arena here. Hashtag VIP boxing live. Get your questions in for Ryan. He's not going to be here for too long, so don't miss your chance. We've had one question so far, and it's about his eyebrows. We weren't thinking that when we were asking for questions, but anything you want to ask him, send it in. Here we go, the fourth and final round. Monaghan's just got to stay alert here, stay sharp, keep doing what he's doing with the jab. Like that.
Oh, great left up. Puts the pressure on now.
Here we go.
He's going to finish him.
That left up really hurt him. He's jumping on him now.
Oh, he's going to go. Straight shots.
Studzinski's hard as nails. He's bounced back. It seems okay, but that body shot really hurt him. Monaghan showing his power in there tonight.
Great shots up and down. It's just telegraphing that shot. Seats going for little walks. They're feeling the pace now, being
that's
the final round.
Shot. He's really putting the pressure on here. He went for a little walk and now he's back on him, back on his chest.
Ferocious pace.
We said this could be fight of the night and it's turning out that way, it's cracker. Just had a tweet, pressure him a bit more and finish him on the ropes. I think that's spot on. Body shot hurt him.
Monaghan's just telegraphing that left hook a little bit to the body for me. Disguise it a little bit better.
I mean, Studzinski doesn't look like he's got much left. He's firing back, but there's no bite in his shots anymore. It's a great performance by Monaghan.
Solid performance.
Great shot again. Great. He's hurt.
Great
shot. The referee's
shot.
Having a look.
Ooh.
He's got to be careful he doesn't get caught on the way in, though. A hurt fight is a dangerous one. It's a good shot again. Turn into a bit of a tear up here. Great for the fans. I think both men needed that little bit of a break. Blood coming from Monaghan's nose now.
In all fairness, he's set a ferocious pace from round one.
He looked good tonight, looked very good. Looks like he's trying to prove a point after what happened last time out. There goes Studzinski's nose, he's got to get
great
the knockout.
Great fast 1-2 there.
It's a great shot. Studzinski's breathing out the mouth, you can feel he's feeling the pace. Monaghan needs to jump on him. What a great fight that was.
Great last round.
Monaghan win.
Yeah, for me, Monaghan got a clear shutout points decision for me. I think he dominated every round. His punch variation was good. Shutout points decision.
I don't know what's going on Twitter tonight. Here's another question for you. What's your favourite curry? I don't know what's going on with Twitter.
That's absolutely madness. Favourite curry? You know what, I don't really eat them, but I'll probably go for... just go safe and play for a Tico.
Tim Driver on Twitter claiming I've nicked a maroon Mazda. It's not me that the alert went out for, don't worry.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 4 rounds of boxing, has adjudged this particular contest 40 points to 36 points for your winner, Chris Fatboy Monaghan.
Great performance from Chris Monaghan. You can see how much he means to him and his team
your
to get back on the winning
please,
trail.
Always gallant, always tough, Robert Studzinski.